let's go. Let's hear a little bit about yourself. How'd you get into LinksDAO?
Yeah, so I'm Riley. Grew up in Cleveland, Ohio. Big Cleveland sports fan. I played golf my whole life.
Do you see value in tours? And if you do, why? If you don't, why?
There was all this momentum when they started the community.
Yeah.
And like, it takes a little while to do something like go buy or build a golf course. And like, you have to kind of generate excitement, keep the community engaged, keep people like into the idea, into the community. And like, I've been amazed at how just the Discord is just popping off every day. So we gotta keep that momentum going. I think like giving people a reason to like show up and meet each other and like create content and like kind of share in what the community is building is important before we can have the actual end goal.
All right. So what are your favorite parts about the LinksDAO community?
Yeah, so I think like I've made this joke a lot, but like the Venn diagram between people who can like build technology, and you know, I started as a software developer, and like people who play golf and love golf is really tiny. So I've been out there looking for like people who can code, like designers, and like almost none of them are super into golf. So like the moment that I found this community, it was like, oh, like these are my people. You know, there's all kinds of people like doing really cool things, like cooler people than I am. You know, super, super into golf, and you know, people from all kinds of repressive backgrounds. So I think just, you know, access to that community is has been incredible to me, and just, you know, meeting some amazing people like yourself. And
I am pretty amazing. I really, really am.
Yeah.
I'm so amazing that I'm going to look at my interview questions during an interview.
Would you rather LinksDAO buy a course and, you know, say it's not the greatest track, needs just like a facelift, and that's our course, you know, and then hopefully we go on and do bigger, better things? Or would you rather them buy land, wait 2 to 3 years, and we have something spectacular, but you have to wait that time? Where's like your stance on that?
Yeah, I would say for the first one, I kind of like the first idea where it's like, you know, let's hit the ground running, let's build a community around an actual golf course. And it's like such a new idea in the Web3 community that it's like backed by this physical thing and this physical place that people can meet up. So like, if we could just buy a track and just have a place for people to like hang out, go play, it doesn't have to be the greatest course in the world, and just improve it over time, prove that the concept works. And then as you expand, maybe like we build another one in the future or something like that. But
yeah,
I think the quicker that we can have a place to go and meet people and kind of like prove that the community, it works. The worst part about golf is kind of like the stuffy exclusiveness.
I agree.
And like, you know, I got the privilege of kind of growing up around a country club, got to play every day kind of whenever I felt like it. And I didn't realize how much of a privilege that was. And I think like anything that can kind of like democratize golf and, you know, make it a little bit more accessible and modern, I'm definitely behind. And just like the community that you guys have put together is amazing, and couldn't pass it up.
So. Yeah, no, I agree. I hate the stuffiness of golf. I used to go out and play local country clubs and just go barefoot with a t-shirt, and that's what I love. I mean, we don't have to be that loose, but you know, and loose enough to get people more comfortable wanting to get into golf, I think is our goal.
Yeah.
And so, LinksDAO, what are your hopes for LinksDAO? Like, what do you see them being in 5 to 10 years?
Yeah, I mean, it'd be amazing if, you know, the first course really takes off, people love it, and, like, we really prove out. I'm really interested to see how, like, the interplay between the DAO and, like, the corporation kind of plays out and the control that the DAO has, but just seeing, like, you know, if there's a whole network of courses you could play, kind of, like, regionally located where people can pop in and pop out, sort of like a, you know, just like interplay between all the courses and being able to kind of check out different places would be awesome. And if, you know, I happen to move somewhere that was close by, and making that kind of my home track would be a dream for me. So,
So besides LinksDAO, like, what do you do for a day job?
Yeah. So, I started a company about 9 months ago. It's called Leaderboard Golf.
Nice. Yeah. We're using the app out there today. It is sick.
Yeah. So it's a mobile app for golfers to track on course games and wagers and share the results with friends. So, kind of set out to build the app that I would want to use myself on the course and ultimately kind of be like the place of record for golf and a way for people to like track wagers, settle up in Venmo. And it's all kind of based on the handicap system. So.
Yeah. I mean, we were out there using it today, and it is far and above better than any real golf app that I've seen that tracks stats, distances. And now you got his and like includes all the games. So if you're new to golf and you don't know what game to play, it literally maps it out. Like, hey, if you have three people, play a 9-point, like, and that's what we played today. It was awesome.
Yeah, well, thanks for the plug. Appreciate that.
Dude, hell yeah. Dude, thank you so
great
much.
Thanks for coming.
It was awesome. Stick taps from Mike. Mike, you played incredible today. How do you feel?
Feel great, Doug. Thank you.
It's a Tuesday afternoon. It's beautiful. We're out here playing golf.
Yeah, there's nothing better. I literally can't thank you enough for having me here. Really, that was awesome. Awesome course.
This course was designed by Walter Trappist back in,
okay,
you know, the 1918 to 1923. It was reversible.
Damn.
So, like, the old course, St. Andrews, it was a course that could be played, you know, in one direction one day, and then you turn around and play it the exact opposite way the next day. It's okay. Pretty cool. It's all gone now. But we can, you know, the goal is to bring it back.
That's sick. Yeah. So how do you two know each other? What's the relationship?
It's like actually like the long story. I don't know if we
can. Kind of from this place. Kind of from this place.
Yeah, yeah. So like, it all comes out from that, yeah.
If you grew up in the D.C. area, you played out here. Like I had high school golf tryouts out here. We were talking about it on the course. Like come up here at 6 a.m., play in 2.5 hours, get to work by 9. Yeah. I mean, and you've got Marine One flying by.
Yeah, like, that was sick. Yeah, like, you said that was like the presidential helicopter. That was cool.
Yeah, it's awesome. It's a cool place. And then
if you're learning to play golf in the D.C. area, this is like the place people start. So everybody's got that kind of common background, you know.
Oh, I like that.
I think I've told you this. So we're at a club, like, right?
Yeah.
It's nice, but my son, when he came to golf camp here this summer, and anytime he wants to play golf, heck yeah. Like, he's 5 years old.
Yeah.
Hey, dude, where do you want to go? I want to go to East Potomac, Dad. I don't have to wear a shirt with a collar.
Yeah.
Like, let's go. Man, yeah. Let's have fun.
That's, I hope.
It's the best.
My hope is that golf moves in that direction. I've always been a big advocate for, like, I was always the best player in my friend group because I started early. I was just kind of the athlete, but I hated calling shirts. I hated wearing pants. Now I kind of like it because you can get fun with it, but I hope golf moves in that direction where it's like, as long as you play fast, we don't care what you wear. We don't care what you do. As long as you're out of everybody's way and you're not bothering anybody else, you should be able to do and play the game however you want to play the game. I think if Lynx can do that, then we're in good shape.
We're not like the best examples of it right now, but we are living that here already. You know,
okay.
Like that is the cool thing about here. It's like got a really wide community, represents the whole city. It's just a great place that, you know, has its own unique community that's built up over the years, and it makes it special.
The cool part about Lynx is the community, to exactly what you said, and it's a bunch of people who are just interested in golf, making golf more accessible, making it less snooty, right?
Yeah.
And like, hey, it's about having fun, coming outside, playing some music, having a couple beers with your friends outdoors.
Yeah, didn't think the hip hop was you. I didn't see that one coming. I really didn't. I was like, damn, we got a little bit of Wheezy going on the course. This is nice.
So it was my first NFT. Like, I didn't know what, or I knew what they were, but I wasn't into NFTs. Now I'm deep into that. But
that's awesome.
And I think that's what National Links Trust is in a different way, right? It's like a chance to get out, play golf, meet some people, not be too hoity-toity about it.
Yeah.
And the tour is a great example of like, hey, this is a network opportunity to like meet some interesting people who are doing cool stuff, show off my home, which is the DC area, show off a place I really like, which is East Potomac. So I think that's the why.
That's awesome. No, I love to hear that. I always ask people and then I'm like, I should probably just give them the camera and walk away because I don't want them saying like, oh yeah, that was awesome. Then they go on Twitter and be like, what a joke that dude was. You know, I believe I just spent 18 holes with this dude. Oh, but that was fun. I won't lie. That's probably, I got to count up the scores. I know we got to flip the scorecards, but I think I shot like pretty well.
I think we're like three guys in the 30s on the front.
I think we are either low 80s or high 70s. I think we might have high 70s scorecards.
Which that may not sound great to you, but
what do you shoot?
It's good for us.
Oh no, no, that would be good for me. I'm all over the map.
No.
What do you shoot? 95. What's your hand again? 75. 10. I just like a wide variance 10.
Is it 10?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You shot a 75 and you're a 10.
Yeah.
That doesn't make sense. You're a 10.
What'd you used to be?
I probably used to be like a 3.
But oh, like, okay. So you got it.
I have two kids.
Little kids, man. We talked about it out there.
I play with as kids.
Yeah.
They're like, yeah, man, tough to get out. This is the only excuse I had.
Yeah.
That's the other thing. It was an excuse to get out and play golf during the work
time. Yeah. That's awesome. I'm going to turn the camera off. But Mike, it was awesome playing golf the other day.
Thank you, Doug.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well.
Appreciate
it. Great.
You.